Hi, I'm QDC. What we're going to build today is Dragon's March to the West. This is four figures in this particular set, and for this particular video, I'm only building only one of them. The reason why I'm going to build this kit today is mostly because of my job. Normally, I would like to build a more complex kit, for example, like a tank or a car or an airplane, but I can't because my job, I'm getting more and more busy at work. But the reason why I like to build kits in general is not to entertain you, the audience, but really just to help me enjoy my life, because this is fun. I really like it. So let's go ahead and start building this kit right now. Let's go take a look inside this box. These figures are very typical of Dragon figures. They're very well detailed, but what I want to focus your attention on are the small arms. These are known as Generation 2, and the reason why they call it Generation 2 is because these small arms are very well detailed. Okay, so building this particular kit is going to be very, very easy. The instructions are in the back, and it's very, very straightforward. You can't go wrong. Now, building this particular figure is going to be kind of boring, and I don't want to bore you. So today, I'm going to perform some magic and speed up my process of building this model kit. For those of you who are Doctor Who fans, who watch Doctor Who on TV, you know what I have in my hand. It's the Dr. Sonic screwdriver. And I'm going to use the Dr. Sonic screwdriver to perform some magic. So I'm going to turn on the Dr. screwdriver. And now I'm going to use the Dr. Sonic screwdriver to perform some magic. This is the completed model kit before painting, and it's very good. This is everything I expected from Dragon. Dragon, when it comes to their, well, everything really, they're highly detailed. No flaws, and this is an excellent figure. Now it's time for me to paint it. I'm going to paint the highlights on the soldier's uniform, and I'm going to start off with the arm first. Now I'm going to add a very light highlight. This is the completed model figure. It looks very nice, very well detailed, and I did a good job on painting this figure. Now it's time for me to start making the diorama.
Alright, so I just finished painting the entire figure right here, and now it's time for me to actually build the base for it. Now, I'm going to be a little more fancier in building a base for this particular kit. I'm going to make it very, very fancy. And so in order for me to do that, I'm going to take you to a field trip over to my local home center, and I want to show you how creative that we're going to get making a base for this little guy. Let's go. All right, so we're at my local home center, and the reason why I brought you here is because I want to really show you about some creative ideas about what you could use at your local home center to make some really cool wooden bases. Alright, so we're at the molding section here at the home center, and I want to show you this particular molding. This is a nice molding right here, and I want to show you another molding. This one over here. With this molding and this molding, when we put these two together, I think we're going to have a pretty good looking base. Okay, we're back. So what I have in my hand are two pieces of molding, this molding here and this molding right over here. This particular molding, the original intent is to actually put it onto window frames right over here to make the window frame look prettier. And same thing with this one over here. This one actually was used to put onto the corner of a window frame right over here. Now what we're going to do today is that we're going to add put together this molding and this molding together like this and make it into a very cool looking base. I want to make a perfect joint for all three sides when I put all four sides when I put this together. And in order for me to do that, I need to make a 45 degree cut on this edge right here. And in order for me to do that, I need to use this miter box right here. All four pieces have been mitered to a 45 degree angle, and it's now ready to be glued onto the base right here. So I'm going to use ordinary wood carpenter's glue and glue it on. I'm going to stain the base. What you see right here is ordinary wood stain, and I'm going to use this and spread this all over the base to stain it. I'm going to add the ground material, and I'm going to use pre-mixed tile grout as my ground base. I'm going to add a wash. What you see right here is a dilution of artist oil paint and mineral spirits. And I'm just going to simply apply it onto the base. I'm going to add some grass, and I need to put on some glue in order for me to do that. I'm going to add cut pieces of rope as tall grass. Now I'm going to add some various static grass and other ground material, and I'm going to sprinkle it onto the rest of the glue. Alright, so I built the figure, I painted it, then I made the base, made it look very, very nice, and now it's time for me to show you everything that I've done. Take a look.
This is the completed model project from start to finish, and I like it a lot. The figure is very well detailed, very well painted. The groundwork looks very realistic, and the base looks phenomenal. A very impressive looking base. And for those of you who don't know who this soldier is, his title is called Panzerpionier, which means a combat engineer. And he's holding what is known as a Rolladungsstei, which is basically a United States version of the Bangalore torpedo. It's basically a explosive device in a tube. And what he's also holding, I think, is a smoke canister. Very well detailed, and I like it a lot.
That completes this model kit. This was a fun kit to build. That one figure turned out to look pretty nice, and the base looks pretty nice too. What you're about to see next is a video slideshow of my entire model kit. But before I go, as always, just because I put this video here on YouTube, it doesn't make me a model kit expert. I am not an expert. I'm just a regular guy, just like you. I hope this video encourages you to build a model kit of your own. Either it's a model tank, a model plane, a model figure, or even an automobile. It doesn't matter. In the end, it's all about having fun. I'm QDC, thanks for watching, and always, please, have a great day.
Six, eight, six, eight, six.